In this video session, we are going to study what is a low pass filter. Now, just to brief you up, what does a filter actually mean? Now, filter is actually an electronic circuit which operates on a signal in terms of frequency. That is, if at all, from an input signal, if we want to segregate the components on the basis of frequency, then we use filters like low pass filter, high pass filter, and band pass filter, right? So one by one, we'll be talking about these filters. In this particular video, we are going to talk of low pass filter. Now, a low pass filter is a filter that passes the signal with a frequency lower than a selected cutoff frequency and attenuates the signals with frequencies higher than the cutoff frequency. So basically, when you apply an input to a low pass filter, and suppose you have set a cutoff frequency FC at suppose 2 kilohertz. Okay, so a low pass filter will actually allow all the signals having frequency below 2 kilohertz to pass through, and it will block the other signals. Okay, so now filters, again, we can have of we can divide them into two categories. One is passive and one is active. Okay, passive is what you can see on your screen. Passive filters, they do not actually amplify the signal. They will simply perform the filtering task, and at the magnitude part, they do not do perform any action. So if at all there are certain losses taking place, this low pass filter cannot actually take care of that. Okay, but if you have an active low pass filter is a passive low pass filter attached with an amplifier. So in that case, if there is a magnitude loss taking place, if there is a loss in signal taking place, the amplifier stage that is attached to it actually can take care. Now in this particular, you see, when you see the circuit, it's a very small and a very simple circuit, just one resistor and capacitor attached, and the output is actually being taken across the capacitor that is attached over here. Okay, so now how this is actually working like a low pass filter? If this filtering process actually it revolves around one very basic fundamental, that is the reactance of a capacitor varies inversely with frequency. So if you remember in your preliminary classes, you must have studied about the capacitance, reactance, impedance, resistance, and all that, right? So reactance of the capacitor is given by the formula that you can see on your screen, that is 1 upon 2 pi FC, where F is the frequency of the input signal. So you can see that the reactance is actually opposite, or you can say that the resistance that the capacitor offers to the input signal is inversely proportional to the frequency of the input signal, right? That means higher the frequency, lower is the resistance offered, lower is the frequency, higher is the resistance offered. Okay. So you can, if you see over here, the input, V in is coming. Okay, it crosses the resistor. Resistor, of course, is a passive device. It behaves similar to all low and high frequency signals. Okay, so it is actually the resistor, through the resistor, the signal is traveling. And when it comes to the capacitor element, when it comes to that point where the capacitor is attached, the high frequency signal actually passes through this capacitor. This capacitor branch behaves like a short circuit. The high frequency signal passes through this capacitor branch and goes into the ground, right? Whereas the low frequency signal, because for a low frequency signal, the capacitance, the resistance offered by the capacitance is very high. So you can say that you can say that it behaves like an open circuit. Right, so the capacitor branch becomes like an infinite resistance branch for low frequency signal. So the low frequency signal cannot go through this branch, and it moves further and it goes to the load whichever is connected parallel to the capacitor. Right, so likewise, this capacitor is actually helping us in filtering out the low and the high frequency. The high frequency passes through it, and the low frequency doesn't pass through that. It gets blocked at that point, and then it can be, from there you can tap that voltage and measure the low frequency signal, right? So if you have to find out the low pass filter response in terms of voltage, that is V output, will if you see the circuit, it is actually the voltage that is developed across capacitor, right? So that if we have to measure that, we apply the voltage divider rule. We have the voltage applied is V in, and we have two elements, that is resistor and capacitor. So we have to find out what is the voltage that is developed across capacitor. That will be multiplied by the voltage, that is your output. Okay, so V output is V in multiplied by XC upon under root of R square plus XC. This is the formula for voltage division, or you can say the voltage divider rule for this particular circuit. Right, now before in the earlier slide, we have seen that the cutoff frequency FC for this particular circuit is 1 upon 2 pi RC. Resistance, the reactance of the capacitance is 1 upon 2 pi FC. So from the first formula, you can say that R is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC into C. Right, now we place these values of XC and R into the first formula, and then V naught upon V in, that is the gain, okay, voltage gain for a low pass filter denoted by AL, that is V output divided by V input, is 1 upon 2 pi FC divided by under root of 1 upon 2 pi F cutoff frequency into C square plus 1 upon 2 pi FC square. So when you solve this equation, you will get the gain of low pass filter as V naught upon V in is equal to 1 upon under root of 1 plus F upon FC whole square, right? So this formula we have to remember. The AL, you can directly actually place the value of input into this formula, and you can calculate the value of output. Over here, F will be the frequency of the input signal, and FC is the cutoff frequency of this particular filter for which we have designed. So FC will be set by us. Okay. Now, if at all I have to make it active, this was actually a passive low pass filter. Now I want to convert it into an active low pass filter. That means I want to have an amplification stage attached to it. For that, we actually use a device called operational amplifier. Now, an operational amplifier is actually a high gain electronic voltage amplifier with a differential input. A differential input means it needs two inputs and usually a single output. In this configuration, an op-amp produces an output potential that is typically hundreds and thousands of times larger than the potential difference between the input terminals. So op-amp is a very, very wonderful device which is used in almost all amplification circuits. Okay, and it has so many numerous types of configurations. It can add to voltages, it can subtract, it can integrate, it can differentiate. Okay. Although all these configurations, they are not in the scope of your subject, so I'm not going into the electronic details of op-amps. Okay, but what you need to understand is that you can see the figure, this is how it is denoted, and you have the two resistances attached to it. These two resistances are the ones which decide how much amplification factor this particular amplifier is going to offer. So if your input signal is at the negative terminal, that is called inverting op-amp configuration, and in that case the amplification factor is RF upon Rin with a minus sign. Okay, so inverting means your phase reversal will take place. If you're giving a sinusoidal wave, this output will be sinusoidal, magnitude amplified by value A, but it will be opposite. The phase will be opposite. So you'll get an inverted sinusoidal wave if your input is at the negative terminal. If your input is at the positive terminal, then you have the amplification factor of 1 plus RF upon Rin. Now, this RF and RN, this you have to remember, this particular setup of resistances, it is always connected to the negative terminal. Okay, don't get confused with this. You have to remember that this will always be at the negative terminal, and the supply, that is the input signal, can be at the positive terminal or it can be at the negative terminal. So depending upon that, you will select the amplification factor. So here now you can see I have a simple passive low pass filter, and along with that I have what the output of the low pass filter I am giving into as an input to the non-inverting or the positive terminal of the operational amplifier. So at the output I will get a filtered and amplified signal. Okay, so unwanted frequency at the first stage is it is filtered. So the low frequencies that are obtained, they are fed into the amplifier. So for those particular low frequencies, now this amplifier will actually amplify or increase the magnitude by whatever factor we have decided. So at the end, we get filtered as well as amplified output. Why this is important? Because when you have multiple stages in any electronic circuit or in any instrument, you have multiple stages of processing. Okay, you have multiple stages of filtering also many times, or you may be having long distance transmissions, etc. So in all these, at every stage, if there is even small loss taking place, finally the signal becomes so small that you are not able to get any useful information out of it. So usually whenever we are performing this filtering task, we attach one amplifier along with that, or you can say we use active low pass filters so that that loss that is taking place at every step is actually taken care of. Okay, so the formulas will remain the same. Cutoff frequency will remain 1 upon 2 pi RC. The amplification factor will be 1 plus R2 upon R1, provided that I am putting the input at the positive terminal of the operational amplifier. So the final gain, if you see, for an active low pass filter, that is V output by V in, will be multiplication of the two. We have two stages connected in series. For the filtering stage, the output is gain is AL. For the filtering stage, it is for the amplification stage, it is AF. So when I multiply these two, okay, when I multiply these two, I get the final gain for an active low pass filter. So the gain for active low pass filter, that is V output upon V in, is 1 plus R2 by R1 divided by 1 plus F upon FC whole square, where F is the frequency of the input signal and FC is the cutoff frequency in hertz. Okay, and R1 and R2 are the two resistances that we had seen in the op amp diagram. Okay, in the earlier diagrams we had labeled it as R in and RF. So this is actually, just to make it simpler, we are using the terminology R2 and R1. Okay, so this one, till now is a first order system. Okay, you can convert it into a second order active low pass filter by actually, you can, if you see, we have added, that RC combination. If you can, if you see at the positive terminal of the op-amp, earlier I was having only one RC combination. Now I have two RC combinations attached to it. Okay, so this does not actually change the gain. This does not change the cutoff frequency, just that it helps in a faster die down of the circuit. Okay, or you can say that it helps in, normally if you see that whenever, you know, the cutoff frequency is obtained, any electronic circuit, it does not stop at once. Okay, there's a gradual decrease. So you can say that in the output, there is gradually the signal will become feeble, and up to certain extent, you know, some unwanted frequency will be there. So this is, it's not a steep stop. It is a gradual one. So when you are actually adding the second order, or you can also make it third order, that makes that decrease or that decline, it makes it faster. So a second order will actually stop the signal faster as compared to the first order signal. Okay, so this is what an active low pass filter is all about. In the next video, we are going to talk about the active high pass filter.